Professor Dave here. I want to tell you about Hess's law.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Thermochemical equations can be manipulated to give important data about chemical reactions. We can use them to predict exactly how much energy will be absorbed or released by a reaction, which is very important because we don't want any unexpected explosions. There are two ways we can use tabulated thermochemical data to calculate the delta H of any reaction. The first way requires that we manipulate thermochemical equations in specific ways. So let's be aware of some rules. First, if a reaction has a particular delta H, the reverse of the reaction will have the opposite delta H, or the same number with reversed sign. Second, if molar quantities in the equation are multiplied by a coefficient, so is the delta H. So if you double all the substances, double the delta H. These are things we can do to thermochemical data to be able to add equations together to result in a reaction we are curious about. Here's what I mean. Let's say we want to know about the change in enthalpy associated with a reaction, like this one. But it is difficult to measure experimentally. We can take other reactions with known enthalpy changes and rearrange them to align with our equation and get the data we want. The first reaction provided has carbon graphite on the left, which is where we want it. But the equation we want has 2 moles of graphite, so let's double this one. We get 2 moles of everything instead of 1, and we double the delta H. Next, this other one has CO on the right, where we want it, and in the right amount. So all we need to do is add these equations together. The O2 and CO2 will cancel because they are present in the same amounts on both sides, and we are left with the substances in our original equation. Since we added the equations, we also add the delta H's to get the delta H for our equation. This kind of manipulation is allowed by Hess's law. We can manipulate the coefficients of a reaction or reverse its direction in any way necessary as long as we change the delta H associated with it in the appropriate way. Then we add or subtract the equations as necessary to give us precisely the equation in question. The delta H you get by doing the arithmetic will be the delta H for the reaction. Another way to calculate an unknown delta H is to use standard enthalpies of formation. This is denoted by the following symbol, and it represents the enthalpy associated with forming 1 mole of a substance from its respective elements in their standard and most stable state. Most stable state means the most common allotrope, or physical form of an element. So carbon graphite instead of diamond, diatomic oxygen instead of ozone, and so forth. Standard state just refers to standard temperature and pressure, which is room temperature and atmospheric pressure at sea level. That's what is meant by the degree symbol. We can calculate the change in enthalpy for a reaction by adding up the standard heats of formation of the products and then subtracting the sum of the standard heats of formation of the reactants. The heats of formation can be found in your textbook or online, and you just plug them in, multiplying each value by the coefficients in the balanced equation. Let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.